Hey friends, I'm Lindsay. Today I wanted to share with you another thing I wrote, and I'm sitting outside, as you can tell. So you might hear some random things, some bugs buzzing around, and perhaps some crows. There are lots of crows around here, which is really interesting. They're kind of cool, actually. So this is something that I had written. One day I was just sort of starting my day sitting on the couch, and I was just sort of, just getting all of these thoughts coming to me. Sometimes that happens. I just start receiving these thoughts and I just immediately have to start writing stuff down. So the first part is, I guess, sort of in a more like poetic sort of way. And then the second part is more of just sort of like a free write journal bit. So let's do it. I asked for patience, and the universe surely delivered on this request. My heart desires such big and beautiful things. My heart desires freedom and travel to experience the world, to see new things, to meet all kinds of people. Yet I just stay. The time just isn't right. There are roots that hold me here, the roots of patience. My heart desires love, deep, beautiful, soul-expanding love, intimacy, closeness, openness, vulnerability, to learn lessons that come from relationship. Yet I must wait. The time just isn't aligned. My heart desires so deeply to explore, and sometimes it feels I'm running out of time, but this is an illusion. One to test my patience even more. The universe asks that I am challenged to see if I have learned the lesson it has put before me, the lesson I asked for many years ago. When we ask the universe for these things, we never know how they may show up. We never know the path to the thing we have asked for. So be ready. My heart desires so greatly, ready for the expansion through adventure, through love. Yet I'm here, sitting in the void, hoping, having faith. Faith that this call in my heart is here for a reason, and that the universe has something beautiful in store for me. But the time isn't right. It's not aligned in this present moment. So the lesson of patience asks me to stay right now and be present, be grateful for this moment, even with the desires in my heart. It's like my heart is pulling me forward into these things, but these roots are pulling me back down into the here and now, grounded, grounded in presence. Perhaps this is the time to root so that I may rise, steady, with strength, with resilience, with patience. And so that was, I guess, the more poetic part of it. And then I was sitting there and more just wanted to come into me. And some of it's like in a just adding on to what I had written, and some of it's sort of challenging a bit of what I had written before. So I'll read that part to you as well. We are waiting for the reward at the end of the lesson. We think, if I stay in this muck and go through it all, surely I will be rewarded greatly. But perhaps all we are rewarded with is the lesson, which can be beautiful in its own way. But I think many of us are programmed to want this huge payoff for the hard work we are doing. But maybe it's not as big as we think it should be. And so we have to have faith still in this path, even if there isn't a huge reward at the end. For me, in my mind, I want to be rewarded with the travel and adventure and the soul love, but I have to stay on this journey even if that's not the reward at all. I have to have faith that this is the right journey for me, even if I don't receive those things. I can't be on this journey only for those things I'm hoping for. I have to be on this journey for the sake of the journey, because it's what the universe asks of me. So it becomes about trusting and having faith that this is all as it should be, and it will all be much more enjoyable as I surrender to it all. I want to feel the expansion of my heart through these desires, but maybe what I think will expand my heart actually isn't what will provide the most expansion. Perhaps surrendering to the universe and being present is actually the expansion I'm looking for. And maybe I just have to have faith that all of this is right for other reasons that I am not able to see or perceive. Oftentimes we think we know what we want, what should happen, etc. But the universe knows better. We are often so limited in our thinking, in possibilities, even with the greatest imagination, the universe can still always create something even greater because it is limitless and sees and knows all. And as I'm saying all of this, it doesn't mean that we don't have to do any work. Surrendering doesn't mean sitting around and waiting. Surrendering means feeling those desires in your heart, in your soul, and taking steps towards them that you are able to right now. But also surrendering to and allowing what each moment brings to us. To surrender is the art of action and allowing. To surrender is the art of action and allowing. We can become unattached to what is supposed to happen. We take steps and allow the unfoldment from there, and then we take more steps. And so it becomes this beautiful co-creation with the universe. It's not that you are ever alone without the support of the universe, or even that you don't have any control and the universe does it all. It is the union of your free will and the divine flow. The action is your free will and the allowing is the divine flow. And it becomes this beautiful dance between these things. The union of your free will and the divine flow. Bringing this in together is what creates magic. And we get to play in that. That's where the magic happens and we get to create the life we truly want. It's a co-creation with Source by our side. So, I wrote that, I don't know, about a month ago, sometime in March. And yeah, I just love that idea of free will and divine flow and really playing in that, because we always have a choice. But then when we tap into our heart, often we know what direction to take and what feels like that divine flow. So anyway, I just wanted to share that with you. I hope you enjoyed that. Maybe parts of it speak to you. Yeah, thanks for listening and receiving. I'll see you again soon.